In this month's Master's Flight, we're going to be talking about some really geeky winemaking terms. Sommeliers and winemakers alike do use really basic winemaking descriptors like cherry and apple, but they also dive into some pretty geeky terms that describe some very specific flavor compounds that are natural in grapes. So this month, I'm going to give you all the geek speak so you can show up to the next winery really being able to talk the lingo. So the first wine that we have in the flight is our Torrontés. Now, Torrontés is a grape variety that is native to Argentina. It's a spontaneous crossing between the Mission grape, which was planted by the Spaniards all up and down North and South America, and the Muscat grape. You don't really see a lot of Mission grape being planted anymore, but luckily it gave us this gorgeous wine. And Torrontés is really special. This is so delicious. It tastes like lilies and rose petals. On top of that, it's got all these beautiful fruit flavors as well, like grapefruit and green apple. But those flavors of flowers come from a very specific place. They come from terpenes. Now, terpenes are natural flavor compounds that are inherent in some grape varietals. You'll find them in things like Gewürztraminer and Muscat, and of course, Torrontés as well. And it's delicious. All that really bright, fresh acidity really balances out the perfumey nature of this wine, making it an incredible, refreshing summer drink. So the next wine that we have is our Luxe Chardonnay. And Chardonnay is an interesting one. Very typically, people describe it as tasting buttery. And this one is no exception. Yes, when you taste it, on the finish, you get this really long, lingering, buttery flavor. Now there's a reason for that. Chardonnay typically goes through a process called malolactic fermentation. And what that means is that just after the regular fermentation that converts the sugar into alcohol, it's going through another fermentation that is converting the malic acid into lactic acid. Now, malic acid is really intense. It's like really tart green apples. It can sometimes be a little bit harsh. Sometimes winemakers want to leave that in place in white wines where they want a real intense bracing acidity. But sometimes they really want to round that out, and so they'll introduce malolactic fermentation so that malic acid turns into lactic acid, which is the kind of acid that you find in milk. Things like yogurt and sour cream have lactic acid. And so this wine gets creamier and softer, but a byproduct of malolactic fermentation is the production of an organic chemical compound called diacetyl. Now, diacetyl is also what they use to flavor movie popcorn butter. So if you think that your wine tastes like butter, it does, because it has diacetyl in it. So cheers to a little bit of butter in your glass. So the next wine that we're going to try is our Cabernet Sauvignon. And Cabernet is great. It's the most planted grape varietal on the planet. It's extremely popular because it adds wonderful structure to wines. And there's a lot of different flavors in Cabernet. Of course, you get lots of black fruit, things like black cherry and black currant and blackberry. But you also get inherently in Cabernet Sauvignon something that's called pyrazine. And pyrazines are found in grapes in this Cabernet family. So Cabernet Sauvignon has it, Cabernet Franc, Merlot, and even Sauvignon Blanc, which is a relative of Cabernet Sauvignon. Yes, in this wine, a little bit of bell pepper on the finish. And that bell pepper gives a really wonderful savory tone to the wine, which is just delicious and a benchmark flavor in Cabernet Sauvignon. Now, our final wine in the flight is our Shiraz. And Shiraz is great, really powerful, very spicy. Shiraz is the same thing as Syrah. This is the name for it in Australia. And Shiraz has a chemical compound in it called rotundone. It's extremely aromatic, and it's what's responsible for giving wines a flavor that's like rosemary or black pepper or clove. Really spicy, really peppery flavors. So I get that on this wine. Particularly, once I've got it in my mouth, I can get all that really juicy, rich black fruit and this nice peppery finish on the wine. So delicious stuff. Now that you're armed with all of the geek speak, this will give you an opportunity to understand what makes all of these different varietals taste as unique as they do, and it'll give you something fun to talk about at your next wine party. Cheers.